गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. द पार्ट 5 ऑफ द लेसन केमिकल काइनेटिक्स इज सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड रेट इक्वेशन. द इंटीग्रेटेड रेट इक्वेशन कैन बी यूज्ड बाय द वेरियस वे. सो द फर्स्ट इज द ऑर्डर. दिस इज द सिग्निफिकेंस ऑफ इंटीग्रेटेड रेट इक्वेशन. सो फर्स्ट इज द ऑर्डर ऑफ रिएक्शन. ऑल रिएक्शंस ऑफ फर्स्ट ऑर्डर ओबे the following equation, and the equation which we have discussed earlier, that is K is equals to 2.303 upon T log R initial upon R. So all the first order of reaction follow this equation. Starting with the known concentration of R at the initial condition, we know the concentration of R. The concentration of the reactant R at the different interval of time, and here the time is represented by the T, may be measured. By this method, we can measure the value of T, we can measure the value of R, and the value of the molar concentration of the reactant at the different time interval are substituted in the above equation. This is the equation, and if the value of the K comes out to be constant, then the reaction is of the first order. So this is one of the significance, because we get this equation from the integrated rate equation. So this is the first significance of the integrated rate equation. Now let us discuss about the second significance, and the second significance is the calculation of rate constant. This is the second significance, that is the calculation of rate constant. So the integrated rate equation can be used to calculate the rate constant. We all are aware of the rate constant. So by the use of the integrated rate equation, we can easily find the rate constant of a reaction. So if the reaction is known to be of first order, then by substituting the initial concentration of the reactant, and we know that the initial concentration is represented by R0. This is the initial concentration of the reactant, and the concentrated concentration at the different time. And here we are representing the time by the alphabet T. So the equation which we have discussed earlier, it can be represented at, that is KT upon 2.303 log R0, R initial upon R. So this equation we get from this equation. We have done the rearrangement of this equation, and we get such a equation. So now we can also solve it as, that is KT upon 2.303 is equals to, that is log, first of all, R0 minus log R. That is, we extend this term, log R0 upon R. We extend this term, that is log R0 minus log R. Or we can say that is log R is equals to minus KT upon, this goes here, so it become minus KT minus 2.303, or we can write KT here, or we can write T here, T plus log R0. By rearranging, we have done nothing, only we have done the rearrangement. If you want to find out the value of log R, so we rearrange the equation and we get such an equation. So this equation is comparable to the equation of the straight line. This equation is comparable to the equation of the straight line. When the graph is plotted between the log R, that is the reactant, final concentration of the reactant, and the time T at different interval of time, we get the straight line. The graph is of the straight line. So it should be clear that the slope of line is equals to minus k upon 2.303. This is the slope of the graph. How we get when we plot a graph, and how we plot a graph? That is, this is log R, this is the remaining concentration of the reactant, and this is the time T. This is the time T. So the graph, and here this is the log R0. That log R0 is the initial concentration. Log R0 is the initial concentration, and if we want, these are the different time intervals. So the slope is minus k upon 2.303. So this is the another significance or another importance of the integrated rate equation. Now the next topic is half life period of a reaction. Now we under this topic we have to discuss the half life period of the zero order of reaction and the first order of reaction only. So first of all, let's discuss what is half life. So half life period, it is clear from the name that half life period of a reaction is defined as the time during which the concentration of a reactant, is reduced to half of its initial concentration. When the half of the concentration is utilized or half of the concentration is left, that is known as the half-life of a reaction. Or in other word, we can say that the time in which half of the reactant is completed. It is also known as the half-life, a period of a reaction, and it is designated by T 1 by 2. It is designated or denoted by T 1 by 2. That is, 1 by 2 means half. 1 by 2 term is used for half. So time, half of the time is passed. That is called the half-life period. So the half-life period for the different order of reaction, we can easily calculate the half-life period for the different type of the reaction. So the first is half-life period for zero order reaction. Half-life period for zero order reaction. So let's calculate the half-life period for the zero order reaction, and for that we have considered a zero order reaction. First of all, we have considered a zero order reaction. So let us assume that A is the reactant and it gives the product. So the rate constant, if we want to find out the rate constant for this reaction, so rate constant is designated by K. So K is equals to A naught, that is the initial concentration, minus A, that is the final concentration, divided by the time. So this is the rate constant for this reaction. Now half-life period correspond to time taken during which the initial concentration, and in this reaction, which one is the initial concentration? A naught, A0 is the initial concentration. So during which the A0, A0 is reduced to half. This one is reduced to half. So at T1 by 2, that is the half-life period. At T1 by 2, A is equals to A0 by 2. A is equals to A0 by 2. Now put this value of A to this reaction. Let us consider this is the equation number 1. So we have to put this value over here. So we have K is equals to A naught is equals to A naught we had taken from here. The A naught is same here. That is, sorry, not is equal to, that is minus A naught divided by 2, and here now T is T half. Now the value of T is T half. That is, value is T half. So we have, I have put here T half. So when we solve this equation, so I have A naught upon 2 T 1 by 2. After solving this equation, I have A naught upon 2 T 1 by 2. Or we can say that if we want to find out the half-life period, that is 1 by 2. The designation for the half-life period is 1 by 2. So, T 1 by 2 is equal to A naught is same. Now, this we exchange the T half with the K. So, here we have 2K. That is T half is equal to A naught upon 2K. So this is the formula to find out the half-life period of a zero order of reaction. Now it is clear that T half for the zero order reaction is directly proportional to what is this? A naught, this is the initial concentration. A0 is the initial concentration. So T half for the zero order of reaction is directly proportional to the initial concentration of, this is the initial concentration of reactant. Initial concentration of reactant, and inversely proportional to K. And what is K? K is the rate constant. So this is the formula for the half-life period of a zero order of reaction. Now let us calculate, let us find the half-life period for first order reaction. Now this is the half-life period for the first order of reaction. Now again, for that, let us assume a reaction, that is A gives product. A is the reactant. And it gives the product. Now, by applying the equation, we have KT is equals to 2.303. KT is equals to 2.303 log. We have in the formula of the first order of reaction for the integrated rate law, here we have the R naught, because that time we have the reactant R. So here I am having the A0. We are expressing the reactant as a A0 or A term. So KT is equals to 2.303 log A naught upon A. Now by rearranging this equation, we have done nothing, only we have done the rearrangement for the time, because we want to find out the half life period. So first of all, we have to arrange the formula according to the time. So T is equal to 2.303 upon K. This K goes here, 2.303 upon K, and rest of the things are the same, that is A naught upon A. A naught upon A. Now, half life period corresponds to, the meaning is the same. The half life period corresponds to the time during which the initial concentration, here the initial concentration again is the A naught, is the initial concentration is reduced to its half, is reduced to its half. Now the values are same, means A is equals to, that is A naught by 2. The value of A is equals to the A naught 2, and T is equal to, for the half life period we have taken the formula, T is equal to T 1 by 2. Now put these value over here in this reaction, these value should be, we should put these value over here. So in place of T, first of all we have to place T 1 by 2, T 1 by 2 in place of T, because the value T is similar to the T half. So T 1 by 2 is equals to 2.303 upon K. It will remain same. 2.303 upon K. It will remain same. Only the change will takes place here. That is A naught. Now here, that is A naught by 2. A naught by 2. Now after solving this equation, we have 2.303 upon K. It was same. It was same. Now, in place of this one, this is the log 2. This is the log 2. Because we cancel these both terms, and this one is the log 2. So, or we can also express it as a 2.303. And what is the value of log 2? The value of log 2 is, that is multiplied 0.3010. This is the value of log 2, and we have taken this value from the log table, and K is same. So when we solve this equation, we get 0.693 upon K. 0.693 upon K. So we can say that T 1 by 2 is equals to 0.693 upon K. Now this is the half life period for the first order reaction. This is the half life period for the first order reaction. Therefore, the half life period of a first order reaction is independent of the initial concentration. Independent of the initial concentration. Whereas in case of the zero order reaction, the half life period is directly proportional to the initial concentration. But here in case of the first order reaction, the half life period is independent of the initial concentration of the reactant. Now further, it is also clear from the relation of the half life period for the first order of reaction, that the half life period for the first order of reaction is inversely proportional to the K. And what is K? K is the rate constant. So half life period is inversely proportional to K, that is the rate constant. K is the rate constant, but it is independent of the initial concentration. So with the help of these two formulas which we have done, so with the help of these two formula, you can easily find out the half life period, or you can easily find out the rate constant when the half-life period was given. So apply this formula on the numerical and easily find out the answer. Now the last topic of this chapter is pseudo. PSEUDO, that is the P, again I write here, PSEUDO, that is the pseudo chemical reaction is the last topic. So the pseudo chemical reactions are defined as the reactions which are not truly of first order. The reactions which are not truly of first order, but under certain specific conditions, they became reaction of first order. They are not first order reaction, but under certain specific condition, they became the reaction of the first order. So they are known as the pseudo order reaction.